Robert, Mike Tyson's record was 50 wins and 6 losses. What does that mean to have losses in boxing? Because everybody in this day and age are so obsessed with undefeated.
I want to be undefeated, no?
I want that O.
Hey, sometimes you lose from a loss. You know, I'm not saying that's Mike Tyson's case because, you know, he had other issues. You know,
Muhammad Ali lost,
and he's the best.
Sugar Ray Leonard lost.
Exactly.
Duran lost.
Sometimes they need to lose to learn and to get better, to make themselves better. You know, there's only very few people, maybe one person in boxing that zero, that O is the most important thing for them.
Who's that?
Fighting pro debuters. You know who I know that is?
I gotta ask
fighting
you this.
Fighting pro debuters.
What do you tell a fighter after a loss? Because for me, I've been doing this for 12 years. There's nothing I could say because sometimes fighters just want to be left alone. They don't want to hear, oh, keep your head up.
Yeah, but you have to, you know, not at that moment, they don't want to hear you. But after they are,
give
know,
it a day or two, a week. Give them
a day or two to realize that maybe the people that are telling them, that are talking to them, are the people that really love them and that really care for them. Sometimes they lose. Sometimes they get caught and get knocked out. It happens. It's happened before. That doesn't mean that's the end of their career or their life. You know, they're going to continue fighting. That's going to make them better.
You were 32-0, Robert.
Sometimes they get tired. Sometimes they just get cut with one punch. You know, sometimes they injure themselves and they lose the fight. It's the way it happens, the way boxing is.
You were 32-0.
I was 32-0.
How did you take your first loss? Did the world
end?
It was
bad. I lost my title, my world title. I was champion, and I lost to Deo Corrales. It was bad.
He's a legendary
fighter. It was bad that day of the fight, after the fight. I go to the locker room, and then I was the co-main event. The main event was Orlin Norrison versus Mike Tyson. And my dad was training Orlin. So same corner, I lose my fucking world title. I go to the locker room and everybody has to go back to the ring.
So
I'm by myself. I'm in the shower. I just fucking kneel down and fucking the water was running on me and I started crying. But then after that, it's cool. It happens. It's part of the loss. You know,
life goes on. It's not the end of the world.
Then Corrales, his family, his people came to the locker room to give me back my belt. They were cool. Fucking Corrales told me, you know, hey, you know, you were a great champion.
You were winning the fight?
I was, you know, tough kid, you know, it was cool. So that made me feel better. You know, after the fight, when in the ring, my dad told me, look, you won, we've celebrated 32 wins. Now it's time for them to celebrate. So my dad told me, you're gonna go up to him and congratulate him. So I went up to him and congratulated him and told him, you know, wish you the best. I want you to defend your title. You know, it was an honor to lose to somebody that
He's
great.
He's very tall. He was a giant. How did you fight him, Robert?
It was tough.
And he hit hard? Did you become friends with him afterwards? Or?
Not every time we would see each other, we were cool about it. I wasn't, you know, we were not enemies and we were not friends, but we were cool.
When you heard that he passed away, were you shocked?
It was a shock.
In Vegas and he had an accident with the motorcycle?
It was shocking, but... You know, it felt bad, you know, for a great fighter like that, you know, 20's career at such a short age and all that. It was sad.
So if there are fighters watching out there and they just suffered their first loss, what do you tell them?
Stay strong, you know. You know, we have a lot of undefeated kids, but, you know, we've had kids that, you know, Louis lost his first fight with us. At first, I'm sure it wasn't easy.
And now he won four.
It? Yeah.
Now he won four in a row, five in a row.
But you know, exactly. That's what, you just got to motivate him, keep going. You know, that's just the boxing game. Yeah, that's the way it is. You know.
And sometimes the way politics is today, we might see a fighter that loses, but they make sure that he still gets a W or that it's a draw. Sometimes we've seen draws when it's really like they don't want to give the
right.
B side the.
Right, exactly.
So you get the decision.
Yes.
That's the way we look at it.
That's what I look. And
so
life goes on.
It's just the way it is.
But why are we so obsessed with undefeated in this society?
Only
Nobody's
undefeated. Only one person cares about that shit.
Robert.
And he's fighting pro debut guys.
Not everybody.
Guys that are turning pro.
Not That's everybody it. I go to interview gives me an interview. Life goes on.
Life goes on. Fuck it. Can't win them all.
Nope. But do you think that would ever change, that we're going to go back to the old days where winning and losing is just normal?
You know
life.
What I'm talking about?
It's fucking right, man. It's fucking right.
Josue, I was at his fight. You know what happened when they disqualified him, Robert?
I know. I seen the fight.
What a fail. He hits the guy after the bell, and the guy could win an Oscar for that performance.
I know. Hey, okay. Look. It happened, I remember when we still had Victor Ortiz, in Oxnard actually. The ref breaks the fight, so Victor throws a punch, it wasn't even a hard punch. That guy gets here and fucking goes down and goes out.
He oversold it.
He was out. So they disqualified him. Same shit happened to him.
It's part of what happened to Will Jones.
Yeah, Will Jones, this thing.
Yeah?
With the little guy from Chicago.
My friend.
He's a nice guy. I like him. He's in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
He's a good dude. He's a good dude.
My top Griffin.
Very good dude. He works a lot in the community.
We were in the U.S. team together.
Really? He's a very nice guy.
He was an Olympian, 92 Olympian.
Probably the shortest light heavyweight in history.
He's a good dude. But, you know, it happened. He did that, hey. He won the fight.
But, Robert,
he beat Roy Jones. They got a rematch.
It happens in boxing.
Got a rematch. Got another payday. So, fuck it. I would have told my fighters to do the same.
Are you taking notes? Are you taking notes? You should be listening. Robert, tell him what he needs to do if he gets hit after the bell.
Fucking go knock it. Fake it and you win the fight.
I don't know if I can make
it. It's about winning.
Yep.
But it's crazy. Sometimes they enforce the rules, sometimes they don't.
Yeah, that's the joke.
They're not consistent.
Regal
now.
That Rigondeaux fight. He hit him after the bell, but they gave it to Rigondeaux. I was like,
They
stopped the fight, and then. Because they wanted it. So they haven't announced yet the punishment. December 10th, they're going to meet. Khabib and Conor. What are they going to get? No. 6 months, do you think?
I don't know. Isn't Khabib going to fight Mayweather?
Probably.
Another point of view?
Probably.
Probably,
I think Mayweather wins.
Easy.
Easy?
What?
Mayweather Khabib?
Easy.
Mayweather Khabib? I think so, too. He's broke.
Who? He has 800 million. He has 800 million because he can make another 500 million in one night.
He can make another 2 to 3 million and he's good. That's Big G's birthday today.
Big G?
Yeah, it's his birthday today.
Happy birthday. Are you going to sing him happy birthday, Robert?
Why?